What's up, my friend? Welcome back to another video. So today I just wanted to provide a very quick roadmap going into 2025. If you haven't started your business yet, what are the necessary steps you should take? And I want to give you three very simple steps to follow. And this will give you that foundation you need to move on into the years and decades to come. But these steps are very important because they are fundamental to building your business and also building your audience, which eventually are your asset. It's all about building the know, like, and trust factor. So the very first thing you would want to do is to brainstorm your niche, right? So maybe you haven't really figured out exactly what you want to build a business around just yet, which is totally fine. We all start there. But I think a good place to start is to list out all the different passions that you have. What are you very interested in, right? So this might be a list of 5 to 10 things. Maybe it is just one or two things, which makes it even easier. But if you have a big list of things that you like, write them all down. That's step number one. Because you ideally want to build a business around something you actually enjoy doing. Because as a long-term play, you're going to want this to last into the future for decades to come, right? So you would want to build something that you are passionate about talking about for, like, you know, years and years and years of it, ideally. So that's step number one. Step number two is to find out who you want to add value to and how you can add value to them. And the way you can do this is by starting with your existing network. Like, are there people in your circle who are already struggling with a certain problem that maybe lines up with one of those interests that you wrote down, right? So maybe you really love cooking. Maybe that's one of your passions, and someone has a problem with cooking. Maybe they want to know more about diets, and they want to know what dishes they can prepare to help with their diet. Well, that would line up really, really well and give you some sort of a reason, right? And an incentive to maybe pursue that business idea, that passion, and build a business around it. So the whole point of this second step is to intersect, you know, where your passions are, but also find out where you can add value to other people. How can you solve their problems and make their life better? Because that really is what business comes down to, is adding value to other people, right? So if you can take the time to do your research, join some forums and groups and interact with people and find out what they're really struggling with, and ideally if that lines up with what you're passionate about, then that is sort of the perfect intersection and the marriage between the passion and the value, and then you can start building your business around that. Then the final step is step number three, which takes now our formed business idea. So let's say it is cooking, maybe it's vegan recipes or whatever it is. And you want to start creating free regular content for this niche, for this business. And you also want to have a lead magnet attached to it as well. So basically free content, this could be YouTube, it could be social media posts if you want to build your business on social media. Typically, I would recommend using a search engine like YouTube, because it's one of the biggest search engines in the world. It's video based and everyone loves video, and people go looking for answers all the time on YouTube, right? So maybe one week you post about how to cook this recipe. The next week you talk about how to, how to exercise best in order to compensate for a bad diet or something, right? But you want to find a regular rhythm that you commit to in order to release free content on a weekly basis or a regular basis, so that you can start building that audience and they come to know, like, and trust you and expect content regularly from you. So in this way, you're putting out content there first that's free, and you're adding value to other people's lives. And in return, later down the road, you can start to monetize. So when I say lead magnet, this basically is an additional piece of free content that you give them in exchange for their email address. Because the way you build your audience and gather warm leads is by building your email list. And I use Kajabi for this, right? And I host all my lead magnets, landing pages, and lead magnets on there. But basically, at the end of each piece of content, you can point to your freebie. So maybe that's a PDF, or it's a checklist, maybe it's a short video, whatever it is. It's an over-deliver free piece of content that, in exchange for them downloading it, they give you their email address. So you can always follow up later with paid products or things down the line, right? And I've talked about how to build products and monetize in other videos, but if you're just looking for a roadmap to actually get started and start building your business from scratch, these are the three steps I would follow. So number one is to brainstorm your niche, find those passions you like. Number two is to intersect that with value. So how can your passion help other people? And then step number three is to build or create regular free content and also point them to a lead magnet, so you're building your email list along the way. All right, Hope that kind of makes sense. And if you want to take that the next step further, right? So let's say you are putting out that free content and now you want to start building that email list. You might be wondering, what service provider do I use for that? And there are lots of great ones out there. I actually used to use MailChimp, then I moved to ConvertKit, then I moved to Podia, but nowadays I'm hosting everything entirely on Kajabi because it's an all-in-one platform and it's very, very simple to use once you sort of learn the basics. And they host the email marketing for you, they host your email list, and you can build your website, host all your courses, and all that great stuff. It's all in the one place. So maybe you're already starting to do this and you're looking for that platform for your business. I can highly recommend Kajabi. And if you want to take advantage of my extended 30-day free trial, you can find that down below in the description box, whereas they give you a regular 14-day free trial on their website. So you'll get more than double with my link down below, plus two bonus mini courses, Kajabi in 30 days and content marketing for creatives, as well as a thank you for using my link down below. All right, so I really appreciate it. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks again for watching. And if you have any questions, let me know, but I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, take care.